While diagnosed with autism as a toddler, Temple Grandin grew into a young woman who was quite simply a cowgirl with a vision of how animals see the world. She was able to translate that vision to the rest of us. And the result, a revolution in the cattle industry and too many honors to count. The latest being an inductee into the Hall of Great Westerners.
Temple Grandin was born in Boston in 1947 into a post-war world with little understanding of autism, but a supportive family, good teachers, a love for animals, and an obsession that led to a calling would plunge her down a path that reinvented the cattle handling industry and forced the world to reconsider the boundaries of autism. During a summer visit to her aunt's ranch in Arizona, young Temple became obsessed by the squeeze chute used to hold cows in place for inoculation. She noticed the cattle relaxed once they were in the chute and wondered if a similar gadget could help calm her own sometimes overwhelming anxieties. She designed a human squeeze machine still used today by persons with autism. But that was just the beginning. The process made her realize that as a result of her autism, she shared some visual experiences and panic responses with herd animals. That vision led her to pioneer a new approach to cattle handling that included solid-walled, curved chutes with non-slip flooring to prevent overstimulation and agitation within the herd.
The handling systems that she's designed, I've been in multiple facilities myself and with Dr. Grandin, watched them working. The calmness that the animals exhibit makes all of her life's work worthwhile.
It's estimated that half the cattle processed in North America pass through facilities designed by the towering figure now known as Dr. Temple Grandin.
She introduced an entirely different way of doing things and talking about things and measuring things in terms of animal well-being and behavior.
You can't name anybody else in the world that does what she does. The combination of thought and practicality and dedication to the animals and relationship with the industry and so forth.
Dr. Grandin is an internationally acclaimed speaker, author, and Colorado State University professor whose simple philosophy that nature is cruel, but we don't have to be, has become an industry mantra. Her professional accomplishments transcend the cattle business and offer a model of success for those in the autism community.
When my son was diagnosed in 1990, the very first book that I read was Temple's book. She took what her experiences were, she gave them to us. She wrote about them, she talked about them, she shared her life, and that became our beacon. She lives a very important life, and it's impacted me and thousands of people like me.
When HBO turned the story of her early life into a movie called Temple Grandin, millions were captivated by the tale.
So any idea what your major might be? Science, probably psychology.
Oh, you don't have to decide just yet, do you?
It's bigger than boarding school. That's great. Lots of
choices. Danny's looking at you. So you can see all around without moving his head.
So how do you know where he's looking?
His ears. He points his ears where he's looking. See? He's looking at you. And he's looking at those cowboys.
Something about this movie, something about her story, really reaches to people. And I think it's, you know, they look at it and they see, this is not the story of someone unlike me, this is the story of someone like me that I can relate to.
Trust me, we know how different she is.
Different, not less.
Different, but not less.
I've made television movies, I've made big feature films, you know, some of them costing over $100 million, and I've made very tiny movies. This is the one I'm proudest of, this movie. There is nothing like this. And if I did nothing else in my career, I would have done something really, really worth doing.
We know what we see when we look at animals. Temple taught us what they see when they look back. That's her gift.
Now, if you'd like to hear more from Dr. Grandin, we have a full 20-minute interview with her on our website. Just go to okhorizon.com and click click under this week's Value Added.